Friends, welcome back to my channel Cooking with Dimple. Today I will show you a recipe which is baked prawn in banana blossom. So very healthy and tasty, delicious recipe. It's a twist of mota tingri. This is called mota or the banana flour. So here I will take out these portions. These are inside those petals. So peel off the petals and slowly remove all the flowers from inside. So this is very important and a very, very lengthy process. So you can do a day before and keep it in the fridge. So whenever you have time, you can do that, or you can even get it in the market in a peeled form. Next important thing is to, I will show you inside these, there are one thick black color stick, which is quite thick. You can make out, you have to take and remove that, or else it will make your this chops quite bitter. This is a very, very healthy vegetable which is full of iron, and if you make it in a chop form, kids love it. See, I'm removing that black stick from inside. So you have to do that for each and every flower. So these are all I have peeled, and now it is the time to chop. This is the innermost part of that flour, which you do not need to peel. You just need to chop it. So like the cabbage, we do the chopping. So same way we have to chop this. So you can roughly chop it, no need for fine chopping, as anyways you are going to pressure cook it. Till the pressure cooker part, you can do it a day before and cook the next day. So this way, hold and just chop it roughly. So you can see I have chopped this banana flours, washed it thoroughly. After draining it, I will pressure cook it till one whistle. Adding here very little amount of turmeric powder and enough water to pressure cook it. Once it is pressure cooked, it looks like this. Drain off the excess water. You can see I have drained the water and kept it in a bowl. The other ingredients needed are 1 egg, 6 to 7 medium-sized prawns, 7 to 8 chopped prawns, 4 mashed boiled potatoes, breadcrumbs, white oil, ginger and garlic grated, coriander leaves chopped, green chilies chopped, sugar and salt to taste, turmeric powder, red chili powder, lemon juice, roasted spice mix and garam masala powder, and these are the petals to garnish. First step is to, just with the help of your hand, mash the boiled banana flours well so that it becomes little smooth. Just roughly mash it so that it becomes soft, and now add the mashed boiled potatoes inside and again mix it. Potatoes will help you to bind the chops, so that is the reason I have added potatoes, and add sugar, salt, turmeric powder and red chili powder. Mix it thoroughly. Now add the roasted garam masala powder and the regular garam masala powder. And in the roasted garam masala, I will write in the description box the spices I have roasted. So 1 teaspoon of both goes in. Take a non-stick pan and add 1 teaspoon of white oil. The reason for using a non-stick pan is that you can use very less oil. Heat the oil properly and first thing which will go in is ginger and garlic grated. Saute the ginger and garlic for few seconds. Do not use the paste. Grated garlic and ginger taste much better. Once it is sauteed well, add this mixture which I made earlier. So this banana mixture, I'm adding it back to the kadhai or the pan and continue to stir. So this way, it a little bit of water, you can see it will dry off. You can see the water has dried off and it is nicely sorted. Now add the chopped prawns. Prawns cook faster, so I have added it later on, and adding here lemon juice, 1 tablespoon of lemon juice added. It will enhance the flavor and the taste. Now add 1 bunch of chopped coriander and at least 6 to 7 chopped green chilies. These are the main flavoring agents with the roasted spices. Green chilies goes really well in this dish. Now add little bit of breadcrumbs. The reason for doing that is it will bind the chops very well. And if little bit of water is still left, it will bind it. And so I add it. And now continue to saute it. This sauteing take hardly 5 minutes. So a little bit more of breadcrumbs. And you can see it's almost ready. So this is ready to make chops. I will just allow it to cool. Now break one egg in a bowl. Add little bit of salt. And a little bit of salt goes in the prawns too. Lemon juice goes in the prawn. Very little bit of lemon juice. Just to marinate the fish lightly. And now just whisk the egg with the help of a fork. And just coat the fish with salt and lemon juice. So this banana leaves I will use for cooking as well as plating. Once the mixture has cooled down, take a bowl, a handful of this mixture in your palm, like we do in any kind of chops. In the middle, you add the prawns just to give it a beautiful shape and it looks nice, and if you wish, with the help of a cutter, you can give a shape. So 2 stars I'll make and 2 rounds. So if you want to give a shape, it looks much better. The kids love it, but you can just shape it in a round form too. So nicely give it a shape. And now you can see with the help of a cutter, I will just cut it. Instead of deep frying these chops, I will today cook this in OTG with just very little oil. Now it is ready. Dip it in the egg first. Coat it well and now add in the breadcrumbs. Just coat it with the breadcrumbs so that it doesn't break and it stays crispy. So do that with the help of a spoon so that it doesn't get stuck to your hand. One I have given the shape of a star and another one just a regular just a circle, which is much easier. And today instead of banana leaf, like we cook a lot of things in leaves, so here I'm using this petal to cook my this banana blossom. Same process, dip it in the egg first and then inside the breadcrumbs. This way I will finish the rest of it. Isn't it looking beautiful? It is ready to go inside the OTG. I will just sprinkle a little bit of white oil so that it stays soft and moist. Little bit of oil goes on that foil too so that your banana petals doesn't get stuck. Now this banana blossom goes inside the OTG, which is already preheated, and now I'll cook this in 180 to 200 degrees for I think it will take 20 to 25 minutes to cook. This was cooking for at least 25 minutes in combi mode, convection plus grill, and it is ready. Now I will take a fresh banana petal and just place those baked chops on those banana petals. It will give a color and will look very nice. So it depends upon you the way you want to garnish, but nowadays garnishing is very important, or the plating. So the plate should look attractive. So these prawn in banana blossom are ready and served. Please do share my recipes with your friends and families and leave a comment.